Hi, this is Chris with Dot3D for a quick tutorial on how to reference your Dot3D scans to survey control points in Dot3D 5.0. I'm operating live from an iPad Pro. I'm going to go ahead and switch over to my screen now. So before we move on to the live scanning portion of this tutorial, we've actually skipped ahead with a view of the final result here to help visualize the setup that takes place before scanning when utilizing survey control targeting as shown here today. So as you see on the screen, we have a completed scan of an entire section of a parking lot and building that we'll be doing today. But there was some setup beforehand in terms of these five April tag targets that you see highlighted in green. In order to perform the procedure as shown today, you will need at least three April tag targets scattered throughout your scene at maximum spatial separation to cover as much of the scan as possible. In this case, we have four on the corners of our scan area and a fifth near the start point, just to give you that good 2 to 3 April tags to start and finish at, as we do recommend in just about every scan. Once you've set up your April tags, next you need to determine the coordinates of each tag in terms of X, Y, Z on a local or global coordinate system. This information can be obtained from a variety of methods, such as a surveying total station, a GNSS or RTK receiver, another laser scan, a drone, an existing survey map of the space, or an existing 2D or 3D CAD model of the building or the area. So there are a lot of good ways to get this information, but you will need to obtain it from a third-party method that you trust in order to then apply it to Dot3D after your scan and before you optimize. Okay, so now that we've set up our scene, we're ready to start our scan. So we go back to the gallery view, press new scan, and press the button on the right to begin our scan. We start at an April tag that you see turn orange, and a second April tag. So as a best practice on any scan, even when not using survey targeting, you always want to start and finish at 1 to 3 April tags. In this case, we've gotten 1, 2, and 3. So we're going to come back to those tags at the end of our scan. But otherwise, now we're just going to start moving through our scene as planned and capturing all the data that we need. You'll notice I am swinging by these April tags again just because I happen to have the opportunity here as an instinctive best practice. And now our trajectory is basically just going to be like mowing the lawn here as we move up and down each of these parking spaces that need to be scanned in this scene and capture some of the building as well. So one more time capturing that tag just instinctively, and now we're going to speed up the video a bit as I quickly pan across and capture this entire scene. So you can look away now if the fast forward makes you dizzy at all for the next 20 seconds, but this was a 7-minute total capture time, just walking up and down a large parking lot and collecting all the way up over 1,000 frames, which is a pretty large scan in most cases. Then we're coming back to the same area that we started at and finishing on those same April tags. So as we approach the end of our scan here, we're going to slow things back down to a more reasonable speed and return to the 3 April tags that we started at. It's important to make sure that you turn these April tags orange again when you pan back over them. However, you will notice that over the course of a large scan, when you close the loop, you might see that orange tag showing up in a bit of a different location than the target you're seeing on screen. That is completely normal and is going to be accounted for during the optimization, as you'll see today. So now we finish up with that same tag and press the button on the right to conclude our scan. So it processes locally in a matter of seconds, and we have an immediate preview of the unoptimized data set in its entirety. So everything looks great. This is a complete capture of the space that was needed. If we did need to add more data, you would go to the scan/append button and append in. But if you're happy with what you see in the unoptimized preview, the next step is typically to move forward with optimization. However, in this case, we do want to apply those targeting coordinates before we optimize. So the next step is to input the target coordinates that were collected at the beginning of the video. There are two main ways to achieve this. The first is to enter in the coordinates for each recognized target individually in Dot3D. The second is to load a control file with columns for target ID X, Y, Z. Either way, you want to start by going to the Targets tab that we're now in. And if you're going to enter the coordinates manually, you can pull up from the bottom of the screen to access each recognized editable target. In this case, we actually do have a control file, so we're going to press Load Control File in the top left and open up the target coordinate file that we obtained from a laser scan for this particular scene. And you can select the control target number in blue to see a preview of the file itself. This also shows the formatting that you should be using in your own control targets. So it is first column April tag number, second column X, third Y, fourth Z. Very simple formatting, typically prepared in Excel or another text editor and saved to a TXT format, which can be loaded right into Dot3D. You want to be sure to check your units periodically throughout this whole process. In this case, we are operating in inches, so we're going to leave that as is and press import. Now that the target coordinates have been loaded in, before we optimize, you have to press one more important button, which is the Fit Control Targets button that's now available on the left side of the screen. Once you've selected that, those control targets have been applied and you're ready to optimize. So now we'll press the optimize button up top. And you'll see that Dot3D has automatically checked all the constraints that it's detected and recommends that you utilize for optimization, which is also automatically including the use constraints from targeting checkbox because of what you just set from the targets tab. So you want to make sure to leave all those checked, especially the targeting one, and then hit optimize. Now we're speeding this up 20 times again for your convenience, but it's worth noting that the real-time optimization on device was less than 3 minutes on the tablet in the field. And boom, there she is. You'll notice that any sort of duplication or misalignment from the unoptimized scan has been perfectly cleaned up and crispened, and all targeting constraints have been applied. This is your accurate, referenced, complete, and final data set that you're ready to move forward with. Now, wait a minute. What about these handicap symbols that look like they still have some misalignment or improper overlap? Yeah, no, that's just a repaint job in reality. It had me for a second too, so always remember, the scan probably knows better than you, and make sure to check your real-world conditions before jumping to any conclusions. So this whole scan looks great, very happy with how it's come out. And on top of the visual inspection, we want to compare the targets that we've referenced to the targets in the scan. So if I go to the Targets tab now, and I press Fit Control Targets again, and then tap it a second time, I'm going to get a target fit summary that compares the location of the targets in my scan to the control file. And you see that they're spot on, as we would expect. Everything looks to be within about a tenth of an inch or better. And that accuracy improvement is going to apply not just to these 5 points, but to, you know, any point within the span that you've referenced using survey control targeting. So you're really improving the overall accuracy of your scan by applying these control points, while also referencing it potentially into a larger coordinate system if you're tying into a drone data set or global survey control points, etc. When you move forward now to save and export, this data set will be saved into that coordinate system. So long as you make sure to leave control targets checked as the output transform during save or export, which should be checked automatically after successfully completing the steps of targeting as outlined here today. For more information, please visit www.dot3d.com.